viewers, welcome to Home Cooking with me, Hema Subramanian. Today's recipe is a very exciting Andhra dish. It's Gongura Mamsam. Let's check it out. We're going to take a pressure cooker. We're going to cook the meat first. That is the mutton. Pick some oil. I'm using sesame oil for the recipe. You can use gingerly oil also. Add the whole spices. So I have cinnamon, cloves, cardamom and some fennel seeds. 3 onions that have been finely chopped. 3 green chilies slit, few curry leaves. The onions are nice and brown. I'm going to add 2 teaspoons of ginger garlic paste. Reduce the flame. Now I'm going to add the meat, the mutton pieces. I have 1 kilo of mutton. Turmeric powder, I'm adding 1 teaspoon. Chili powder, you need to add about 4 teaspoons because we're using 1 kilo mutton. Salt. So I'm adding about 1.5 cups of water to the mutton. Pressure cook the mutton till it's nicely cooked. Take a large pot, add a little oil, not too much. Now we're going to cook the gongura leaves. I have 2 bunches here because once it cooks, quantity will reduce. I'm not adding any salt or water to the leaves. We're just going to let it cook by itself. You can see the gongura is cooked beautifully, perfect. Wow, the meat looks perfect. It's cooked beautifully. Added the meat to the gongura. I'm just going to let this simmer for 10 minutes or more till it becomes a nice thick gravy. So the gongura leaves actually very sour and it can be overpowering if you add too much. So if you don't like that sour taste to the mutton curry, you can cut it down a little bit according to your taste. I'm just going to season it with a little salt. So there you have a delicious gongura mamsam. You can try this and enjoy with some lovely steamed rice or with any other main course of your choice. But usually it goes well with steamed rice. Today's recipe is gongura chicken. I have had several requests for this recipe, so I decided to make it for you guys. So let's get started and check out the ingredients. First, I'm going to marinate the chicken. I have about 1 kilo of chicken here. Add 1/2 teaspoon turmeric powder, 2 teaspoons red chili powder, 1 teaspoon salt, 1 whole teaspoon of ginger garlic paste, the juice of 1 lemon, medium size, 1/2 cup curd. Mix all the ingredients together. Make sure the pieces are all well coated with the marinade. Marinate the chicken for about 30 minutes minimum. Take a nice wide saucepan, add a little oil. I've just washed a bunch of gongura leaves here. I'm just going to add all of them. Close the saucepan for a few minutes. Continue to cook the leaves. Now I'm going to add 2 slit green chilies to this. The leaves are cooked well. I'm going to turn off the stove. Cool this mixture and I'm going to grind it in the mixer. Grind it to a nice fine paste. So take a nice wide saucepan. We're going to cook the chicken now. To this, add 2 tablespoons of oil. Add whole spices, cinnamon, clove and cardamom. Teaspoon of cumin seeds. A teaspoon of fennel seeds. Next, add 3 medium-sized sliced onions. Next, add 2 green chilies cut up. The onions are getting to a nice golden brown color. To this, I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste and 1 tomato chopped. To this, I'm going to add a pinch of turmeric powder, teaspoon of chili powder, salt, 1/2 teaspoon garam masala, 1 teaspoon coriander powder. Now add the marinated chicken pieces. Add 1 cup of water and a few curry leaves and cook for about 25 minutes. The chicken is cooked, it's nice and tender. Now add the ground gongura paste to the chicken. Just mix it all together. Season it with salt. Close and cook for another 7 minutes. The gongura chicken is ready. Turn off the stove. So there you go. You've seen how to make this delicious gongura chicken. So do try this recipe and enjoy it. You can have it with some steamed rice. Today's recipe is a lovely pachadi. It's Andhra gongura pachadi. Add 2 teaspoons of oil. Add 2 tablespoons of coriander seeds. 1.5 teaspoons of cumin seeds. 1 teaspoon chana dal. 1/4 teaspoon fenugreek seeds. We're going to make this spicy, so I'm going to add about 20 to 25 red chilies. So roast it for about 2 minutes and then turn off the stove and keep it aside and cool the mixture. Once you've removed the dry ingredients, to the same saucepan, add 2 bunches of gongura leaves and cook it well. So you can see the leaves are turning nice and brown. I've cooked it for about 5 to 7 minutes. So once the leaves have cooked completely, turn off the stove and cool the mixture. So now we're going to grind all the ingredients together. For that, take a mixer, grind them nicely. And then I'm going to add the cooked gongura leaves along with a little rock salt. You don't have to add any water to this and grind it all together. So take a small saucepan, 2 tablespoons of oil. Since it's a pachadi, you want to store it for a few days. You need a little oil in this. To this, add 1 teaspoon urad dal, 1 teaspoon of mustard seeds, 1 teaspoon of asafoetida powder, a few red chilies, garlic cloves, and finally we're going to add a few curry leaves. Transfer the gongura pachadi to the pan and mix it along with the tempered ingredients. So now you know how you can make delicious, spicy and this lovely tangy gongura pachadi at home. So you can try it. You can actually store it in a nice airtight container. Today's recipe is a lovely Andhra dish. It is gongura pappu. Now gongura is otherwise known as sorrel leaves. I'm sure you can easily find them. So let's get started and check out the ingredients for this dish. So these leaves, they are called sorrel leaves in English. In Telugu, we call this gongura. And in Tamil, it's called pulichakira. So you can either chop the gongura leaves like this, or you can use them as a whole. So first, I'm going to pressure cook the dal along with the gongura. I've taken 250 ml of dal. This is tur dal. Add 4 cups of water to cook the dal. Add 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 2 onions chopped, 2 green chilies slit. I'm going to pound a few cloves of garlic. Finally, add the 3/4 bunch of chopped gongura leaves. Since the gongura or the sorrel leaves are very sour, the dal takes longer to cook. So pressure cook for about 15 whistles on medium flame. So now the dal is cooked. I'm just going to use this little masher here that I have to mix everything together. Next, season with salt. So next, I'm going to temper a few ingredients. For this, take 2 teaspoons of ghee. Now I'm using ghee because the flavor will be really good. If you don't want ghee, you can just use oil. Mustard seeds, 1/2 teaspoon. Urad dal, 1 teaspoon. Red chilies, 2. Crushed garlic, 2 cloves. Next, add 1/2 teaspoon asafoetida powder. Turn off the stove and add a few curry leaves. So there you go. It's a very simple dal dish that you can make. If you find these leaves in the market, definitely you should try this. It's a lovely and delicacy. So do try it and you can have it with some ghee and nice steamed rice. You can get a copy of our first edition of the home cooking book on Amazon and 21 Frames.